Dear children, welcome to today's class. As you all know that online teaching and learning methods are being implemented during this COVID-19 pandemic. So one such method we are going to carry on today is teaching through collaboration. Innovative method of teaching involves encouraging students collaboration for various projects. Today, we live in a globalized world and collaboration is an essential life skill. Teaching through collaboration is a life skill that is very essential for all career and enterprises. This can help foster this skill in the classroom by allowing the students to learn, study and work in groups. By assigning group homework or encouraging the students to work together in role plays, presentations, presentation of reports, etc. Today, collaboration is a form of teaching and learning which is gaining acceptance as a powerful tool where once again the responsibility is on the group of students as the educators. They play to the role of guides, mentors, supervisors and for the other students. It also teaches students the qualities like empathy, negotiation skills, teamwork, problem solving abilities. 10th A class is divided into various groups. Group A is presenting the lesson Manufacturing Industries from Geography.
This is Varshit. So today I'm going to teach you some of the topics from the chapter Manufacturing Industries. So now, first let's learn what is manufacturing. So manufacturing means producing new and useful products by processing various raw materials in large quantities. Now for example, हमारे आसपास का furniture,
agricultural equipments and etc.
सब कुछ manufacture होके तो आता है भाई. अभी ये manufacturing industry कौन से sector में है? Sector भी तो important है, लिखना तो पड़ेगा. So कौन से sector में आता है? वो भी एक question. So primary sector में raw materials बनते हैं. Manufacturing industries में आते हैं. Produce होते हैं new products में. और रिलीज उसके बाद ट्रांसपोर्ट करते हैं टर्शियरी सेक्टर से. तो भाई ये मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज ऑब्वियसली सेकेंडरी सेक्टर में है. नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज का इम्पोर्टेंस क्या है? सो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज makes the backbone of general and economic development of a country. In particular, mainly because manufacturing industries not only helps in development and modernizing agricultural activities, but also decrease the amount of dependence of people on agricultural income by providing them jobs in tertiary and secondary sectors. अरे यार, इस दुनिया में कितने लोग एग्रीकल्चर के ऊपर जिएंगे. तो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज टर्शियरी सेक्टर और सेकेंडरी सेक्टर में उनको जॉब्स दिला देती है, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट खत्म कर देते हैं, पॉवर्टी खत्म हो जाती है. सो द सेकेंड पॉइंट, हेल्प्स इन इराडिकेशन ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड पॉवर्टी फ्रॉम अ कंट्री. दिस वॉज द
फिलॉसफी
for the creation of public sector industries and joint sector ventures in India. Second point, next. Export of manufactured goods from a country to another brings new foreign exchange. अरे भाई, इस कंट्री से दूसरे कंट्री में अगर कुछ नया लेकर गए, then we will get something new. यानी उस कंट्री में जो कुछ भी है उसमें से हमें कुछ मिलेगा, हम उसको हमारे लाइफ में इंट्रोड्यूस कर लेंगे. वी विल गेट समथिंग न्यू टू लर्न इन आवर लाइव्स, समथिंग न्यू टू यूज. बहुत सी चीजें जो हमें फॉरेन एक्सचेंज से मिली है, वरना आज भी हम लोग इडली डोसा खा रहे थे. नेक्स्ट, कंट्रीज विच हैव ऑल विच हैव transform their raw materials into new and useful goods have always been prosperous. Obviously, क्योंकि उनको कुछ नया सीखने को मिलता है एक कंट्री से दूसरी कंट्री में ट्रांसफर करने में, रॉ मटीरियल्स को कन्वर्ट करने से उनको कुछ और नया मिलता है. They have always been prosperous.
As we saw the importance of manufacturing sector, now I'm Manogya Karamchedi going to explain you about the contribution of industries to the national economy. Here we'll see that how much did the industries contributed to a national economy. Over the last two decades, the share of manufacturing sector was stagnated at 17% of GDP out of 27%, which means over the last 20 years, the share of manufacturing sector was stuck at 17% out of 27%, where rest 10% was for quarrying, mining, electricity and gas. This is much lower in comparison to some East Asian economies. Some East Asian economies like China, Japan, South Korea, they contribute nearly 25 to 35% per annum in manufacturing industry, which is also double. Because here, our manufacturing industry was struck at 17% over last two decades. The desired growth rate over the next decade is 12%. However, over the last decade, it was 7% per annum, which means we can expect that the growth rate over next decade will be increased by 12% per annum. But in the last decade, it was increased by 7% per annum. Since 2003, the manufacturing sector was once again growing at the rate of 9 to 10% per annum. And we can also expect that it will grow till 12% per annum. The National Manufacturing Competitiveness Council was set up to gain the growth of the manufacturing sector. Yes, it was an organization set up by the government to energize and sustain the growth of manufacturing sector in India. Let us see a graph which tells about the distribution of gross domestic product across economic sectors from 2009 to 2019. Here, the silver part refers to service sector, dark blue part refers to industry sector, blue part refers to agriculture sector. If we see only industry sector, this was getting decreased by year to year. So in 2009, it was 31%. By 2019, it was decreased by 24%. So here the question arises, why the GDP is getting decreased? So the GDP is getting decreased because of several reasons, like agricultural crisis, poor condition of banking sector, environmental destructions, decline in investments. These are few reasons why the GDP is getting decreased. Now, the next topic will be explained by Preeti Aditya.
Obviously, now I have chosen a place, but I also have to keep in mind that is jagah pe kitni production cost aayegi. So these are the few factors which an industrialist look for while putting up a factory. But it is rarely possible to find all these factors available at one place. Basically, the manufacturing activities tends to locate at the most appropriate place where all these factors are either available or can be arranged at lower cost. Now, industrialization and urbanization goes hand in hand. Ek factory lagai hai, to logo ko job mil gaya, aas paas living banega, ghar banegi, shops banega for the needs, right? Sometimes they are located in or near the city. Kabhi aapne dekha hoga ki cities ke kuch hi dur industries rehte hain. Ye isliye taki labors dhoondne mein zyada mushkil na ho. Cities provide markets and services such as banking, insurance, transport, labor, etc. to the industries. That's why there are very few places where all these factors are available. And these places are known as agglomeration economy. Many industries make use of advantages offered by the urban centers known as agglomeration economy. Now let's look into the chart industry and market linkage. So the input raw material and the component part and the factors of production. After checking all these, they start their production. Transport se hum bechte hain factory mein products bante hain, output bante hain, fir usse transport karte hain market mein, bech dete hain. तो इस पूरे प्रोसेस को हेल्प करता है मनी. आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड. आई विल मीट यू सून विद अनदर टॉपिक. टिल देन रजत ठाकुर इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ इंडस्ट्री.
मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री को छोटे छोटे पार्ट्स में डिवाइड किया है, इसके अंदर हम वो देखेंगे. सो टू क्लासीफाई मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री वी आर हैविंग सम बेसिस. दीज आर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल वी आर हैविंग एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री एंड मिनरल बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री. सिमिलरली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मेन रूल वी आर हैविंग बेसिक इंडस्ट्री एंड कंज्यूमर इंडस्ट्री. और बल्क और वेट के हिसाब से हमारे पास हैवी इंडस्ट्री और लाइट इंडस्ट्री. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट वी आर हैविंग स्मॉल स्केल एंड लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज. सिमिलरली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ओनरशिप वी आर हैविंग पब्लिक सेक्टर, प्राइवेट सेक्टर, ज्वाइंट सेक्टर एंड कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर. सो दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैनुफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री. सो लेट्स लुक एट देम वेरी क्लोजली एंड क्लियरली. तो फर्स्ट हमारा ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल हमारे पास फर्स्ट एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री. इसमें क्या होता है, जो भी रॉ मटेरियल होता है, जो भी इनपुट होता है, वो हम डायरेक्टली एग्रीकल्चर ले लेते हैं. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नेम्ड एज एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री. इसके एग्जांपल्स हैं कॉटन इंडस्ट्री एंड जूट इंडस्ट्री एट्सेट्रा. नेक्स्ट होता है हमारे पास मिनरल बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री. मिनरल बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री में जो रॉ मटेरियल होता है वो होता है मिनरल, जिसको हम ओर से या फिर माइन से एक्सट्रैक्ट करते हैं. तो इसके सिंपल एग्जाम्पल हैं आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री एट्सेट्रा. नेक्स्ट हमारा on the basis of their main role how we classify the manufacturing industry. तो इसका है हमारे पास first basic industry. provide their product as raw material to manufacture other goods. simple है इसका. the output of these industry work as input for the other industry. for example हमारे पास iron है. iron जो है एक basic industry का product है. अब जिसको आगे इंडस्ट्री बनानी है उसको पहले बिल्डिंग चाहिए. बिल्डिंग बनाने के लिए हमें आयरन चाहिए, साथ ही साथ उसे मशीन भी लेनी है. मशीन भी में भी हम आयरन यूज करेंगे. दैट्स व्हाई द आयरन इज वर्किंग हियर एज रॉ मटेरियल और इनपुट फॉर द अदर इंडस्ट्री. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज बेसिक इंडस्ट्री. नेक्स्ट हमारा कंज्यूमर इंडस्ट्री. कंज्यूमर इंडस्ट्री का सिंपल है प्रोड्यूस गुड्स फॉर डायरेक्ट यूज. मतलब सिंपल डायरेक्ट यूज के लिए हमें चाहिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल टूथपेस्ट. टूथपेस्ट को हम आगे प्रोसेस नहीं कर सकते हैं, उससे कोई नया प्रोडक्ट नहीं बना सकते हैं. हम सिंपल डायरेक्ट यूज के लिए उसको यूज करते हैं. दैट इज द एग्जांपल ऑफ कंज्यूमर इंडस्ट्री. सो नाउ वी आर हैविंग द स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री एंड लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री. सो स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री में क्या होता है, इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ मनी कैपिटल इज लेस देन 1 करोड़ रुपए. जिस भी इंडस्ट्री में 1 करोड़ रुपए से कम इन्वेस्टमेंट होगा, कम मनी यूज होगा, वो उसको हम बोल देंगे स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री. इसके एग्जांपल है मैट इंडस्ट्री, फर्नीचर मेकिंग इंडस्ट्री. मैट और फर्नीचर बनाने के लिए हमें कोई ज्यादा पैसे नहीं चाहिए, थोड़े से पैसे में हम ये बना सकते हैं. दैट्स व्हाई इट कम अंडर स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री. नेक्स्ट हमारा लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री. इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ कैपिटल इज मोर देन 1 करोड़ रुपए. मतलब जिस भी इंडस्ट्री में 1 करोड़ रुपए से ज्यादा मनी यूज होगा वो आएगा अंडर लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री. इसके एग्जाम्पल हैं आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री, पेट्रोकेमिकल इंडस्ट्री. बट यहाँ एक पॉइंट है जो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि जो ये 1 करोड़ रुपए है ये हर बार कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यू नहीं है, ये फिक्स्ड वैल्यू नहीं है, ये हर साल चेंज होता है. इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट कि हर साल चेंज होता है, ये एक फिक्स्ड वैल्यू नहीं है. नेक्स्ट हमारा टॉपिक है ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ओनरशिप. तो फर्स्ट वी आर हैविंग पब्लिक सेक्टर. पब्लिक सेक्टर क्या है, ओन्ड ऑपरेटेड एंड मैनेज्ड और मेंटेन्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट. तो ये गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर भी हम इसको बोल सकते हैं. इसके एग्जाम्पल हैं भेल, सेल और IISCO. तो ये हैं इसके एग्जाम्पल, और भी बहुत सारे हैं. नेक्स्ट हमारे पास प्राइवेट सेक्टर. तो ये है ओन्ड ऑपरेटेड एंड मेंटेन्ड बाय इंडिविजुअल और ग्रुप ऑफ इंडिविजुअल. तो इसके एग्जांपल हैं टिस्को, बजाज ऑटो लिमिटेड एट्सेट्रा. तो नेक्स्ट हमारे पास थर्ड है ज्वाइंट सेक्टर. ज्वाइंट सेक्टर जो है पब्लिक और प्राइवेट सेक्टर का कॉम्बिनेशन है. तो ज्वाइंट सेक्टर को हम बोलेंगे ज्वाइंटली रन बाय गवर्नमेंट एंड ग्रुप ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स. तो इसके एग्जाम्पल हैं ऑयल, ऑयल इंडिया लिमिटेड, तो ये इसका एग्जाम्पल है। नेक्स्ट है हमारे पास कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर, उसमें क्या होता है, ओन्ड एंड मैनेज्ड बाय प्रोड्यूसर्स एंड सप्लायर्स ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल, मतलब जो चीज़ की और रॉ मटेरियल ग्रो करेंगे वही उसको प्रोड्यूस करेंगे और वही उसको मैनेज करेंगे और वही उसको सप्लाई करेंगे, तो ये जिस भी सेक्टर में होगा वो कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर होगा। तो इसका एग्जाम्पल है अमूल और श्री महिला गृह उद्योग लिज्जत पापड़, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सेक्टर। नेक्स्ट वी आर हैविंग ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बल्क एंड वेट वी आर हैविंग हैवी इंडस्ट्री, इसमें क्या होगा, जो भी रॉ मटेरियल होगा वो हैवी होगा और जो आउटपुट होगा वो भी हैवी होगा। तो इसका सिंपल डेफिनेशन है, यूज हैवी एंड बल्की रॉ मटेरियल एंड प्रोड्यूस हैवी गुड्स इन लार्ज क्वांटिटी, तो इसका एग्जाम्पल है आयरन एंड स्टील कॉपर स्मेल्टिंग। नेक्स्ट वी आर हैविंग लाइट इंडस्ट्री, इसमें क्या होगा, इनपुट भी लाइट होगा आउटपुट भी लाइट ही निकलेगा, तो इसको हम बोलेंगे यूज लाइट एंड स्मॉल रॉ मटेरियल एंड प्रोड्यूस लाइट गुड्स, तो इसका एग्जाम्पल है इलेक्ट्रिकल टॉयज टूल्स यूटेंसिल्स एटसेट्रा। सो दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री। मूविंग टुवर्ड द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, सो लेट्स रीड अबाउट द एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री इन डिटेल। सो इन एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री फर्स्ट वी आर हैविंग दिस टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री। This industry contributes about 4% towards Indian GDP. With that, this is the only industry which is self-reliant and complete in the value chain. And with that also, it is the second largest employment generating sector in India, which is directly employing 35 million people. So here you can see two pictures. In the picture one, you can see spindle thread in textile industry, and in picture two, you can see colorful threads on a loom in textile industry. Moving towards the next, we are having cotton textile. So Indian cotton textile are from ancient times. You know, khadi, a product from cotton textile, had played a very important role in uniting the nation during the freedom struggle. Yes, this is a very, very important fact about the cotton textile, which proves that cotton textile is from ancient time. So next point we are having is the first successful cotton textile mill was established in Mumbai in year 1854. And in the early years, the cotton textile industry was concentrated in the cotton growing belt of Maharashtra and Gujarat. Why? We will see that. So why cotton textile was concentrated in Maharashtra and Gujarat? Point 1. Availability of raw cotton. 2. Markets. Availability of markets. 3. Is transport facilities including port facilities. 4th is cheap labor. 5th is moist climate. So these are the factors responsible for concentration of cotton textile in Maharashtra and Gujarat. Moving toward the next, we are having India export yarn to Japan. First point. Second, country also export cotton goods to USA, UK, Russia, France, East European countries, Nepal, Singapore, Sri Lanka and African countries. So here we can see that our country India is exporting cotton product or cotton textile to so many countries. So this is a point on which we should feel proud, na? Yes. So India has the second largest installed capacity of spindle in the world after China. India have a very large share in world trade of cotton yarn, about 1/4 of total trade. So last point is, however, our trade in garments is only the 4% of total world's. So we are having next here. So problem that cotton textile industry facing nowadays. So first problem is irregular electricity supply. Problem 2 is old and outdated machine. Problem 3 is low output of labor. Problem 4 is tough competition with synthetic fiber industry. So now we will see the procedure from cotton to cloth. First we take the cotton, then we gin it, or you can say separate the seed from it, and then we will use charkha for making yarn from the cotton. After that, we will मेक और डाई द यार्न देन वी विल मेक फैब्रिक विद द हेल्प ऑफ नीटिंग और आइदर बाय वीविंग एंड आफ्टर दैट वी पैक द फैब्रिक एंड देन इट इज एक्सपोर्टेड टू मार्केट्स और शॉप्स वेयर फ्रॉम वेयर वी गेट इट द क्लोथ्स. So here you can see two pictures. In the picture one, you can see Mahatma Gandhi weaving a cloth with hand loom. And picture two, you can see an old woman with the old fashion or old style. So India is the largest producer of raw jute and jute goods. This is the first point. Most of its mills are located in West Bengal, mainly along the river Hooghly. And the next is, the first jute mill in India was set up near Kolkata in 1859. So, what are the challenges that the jute textile is facing nowadays are? The stiff competition in the international market from synthetic substitutes and from other competitors like Bangladesh, Brazil, Philippines, Egypt and Thailand. Here, यहाँ पे ये point क्या बता रहा है हमें? कि आज के टाइम पे जो है जूट को इतना प्रीफर नहीं किया जाता है इन मेकिंग थिंग्स बिकॉज आज जूट को जो है रिप्लेस कर दिया गया है सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स और सिंथेटिक प्रोडक्ट्स के साथ. मींस जो जूट होता है उसकी रोप बनाई जाती थी, उसके बैग्स होते थे, उसकी बहुत सारे प्रोडक्ट्स होते थे. बट आजकल सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स जो हैं वो बहुत ज़्यादा लॉन्ग लास्टिक होते हैं, ड्यूरेबल होते हैं और अट्रैक्टिव होते हैं. तो इन तीन रीजंस की वजह से हम जो है जूट को जो है अपने पोजीशन से हटाकर हम प्रेफर करते हैं सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स. दैट्स व्हाई जूट इज फेसिंग अ चैलेंज इन इंटरनेशनल मार्केट. विद दैट रीजन इंडिया में हम उतना जूट प्रोड्यूस नहीं कर रहे हैं जितना बांग्लादेश, ब्राजील, फिलीपींस, इजिप्ट और थाईलैंड करते हैं. सो वो भी एक पॉइंट है कि एक चैलेंज खड़ा कर रहा है हमारी जूट टेक्सटाइल के लिए. सो नेक्स्ट वी आर हैविंग फैक्टर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर जूट लोकेशन इन हुगली रीजन. क्या हमारे फैक्टर्स हैं, क्या रीजंस हैं कि जो जूट है वो हुगली रीजन में है? तो उसकी रीजन है एक, प्रेजेंस ऑफ जूट प्रोड्यूसिंग एरिया. कौन सा है? कोलकाता और कैन से वेस्ट बंगाल. नेक्स्ट है हमारा गुड ट्रांसपोर्ट फैसिलिटी. थर्ड है हमारा एबंडेंट वाटर फॉर प्रोसेसिंग रॉ जूट. फोर्थ वन इज चीप लेबर फ्रॉम वेस्ट बंगाल, बिहार, उड़ीसा एंड उत्तर प्रदेश. These four states are providing very cheap labor for the production of jute. और last point है, कोलकाता जो बहुत बड़ा एक सिटी है उसके पास क्या होगा? बैंकिंग के लिए अच्छे हमारे पास वहाँ reasons होंगे, इंश्योरेंस हमें easily मिल जाएगा, port facilities भी अच्छी होंगी. तो वो भी एक reason है जिसको हम बोलेंगे कोलकाता as a large urban center provides banking, insurance and port facilities to export cotton jute goods. Next we are having National Jute Policy of 2005. So what is this? Its main objectives are increasing productivity of jute, improving quality of jute, ensuring good price to the jute farmers. Fourth is enhancing the yield per hectare. So this is the jute policy of 2005. Now we are seeing or going to learn about the sugar, a sense of happiness. Now we are having sugar industry. So the India is the second largest producer of gud, khand, shri. Both of these products are related with sugar and tino sugar, gud or khand, shri. Tino ka jo raw material hai wo sugar cane hi hota hai. Next hai the raw material used is bulky. Bulky isliye kyunki sugar cane hai, bhari hota hai isliye bulky hai. Next hai in 2010 and 11 there were over 662 sugar mills in the country. This is a very important point. And 60% of mills are in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar only. We can say that major sugar industries are located in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar on seeing this point. Next we are having the industry is seasonal. क्यों है seasonal? क्योंकि जो sugar cane है हम उसको हर बार हर महीने नहीं उगा सकते हैं. sugar cane को पूरी तरह से उगाने के लिए हमें एक साल का time चाहिए होता है और उसके बाद उस जब हम उसको काट लेते हैं तब हमें फिर एक साल का उसको gap देना पड़ता है ताकि जो soil है वो अपनी fertility, अपनी water.
Respected Manjulata ma'am and all my dear comrades, today I Lanka Sai Arjun of class 10th A is going to present a short PPT on the topics that are assigned to me, and those topics are, first is the mineral based industries, and the second that we will get to it is pollution due to industrialization and environmental degradation. So my first topic, my friends, is mineral-based industries. Let's begin. So the basis of anything is very vital, very important. That is what we are taught in school. From our primary classes to our secondary ones, we are taught to learn the very basic thing. So let us get to the base of the question. By the word mineral-based industries, first question that arises in our mind is what are mineral-based industries? So mineral-based industries are industries using minerals as the basic raw materials. And these mineral-based industries use basic raw materials such as steel, iron, aluminium, gold, etc. Almost all industrial sectors depend on this industry. Iron and steel industry is also known as the key industry. So next, let's go to the next slide. As you can see here, is the mineral industry. One slide, and these are the mines and quarries that you can find all through India. And some of them I would further explain in my maps. And so next, let's. So the features of mineral-based industries, my friends, we'll get to that point too. Features, some silent features of mineral-based industries are, these industries use mineral, both metallic, non-metallic. And they also use ferrous and non-ferrous. Now let's go some more further. Some mineral industries, as you can see. In one hand, my friends, as you can see it in this diagram and as well as in this, we see that there are some disadvantages and advantages as well. The disadvantages are even mentioned in the diagram, like destruction is there, like fog, like smog and smoke, everything, if you can see it over here, is there. And the advantages are that mineral industries are the key industry of the country. The whole economic sector depends on these industries. It is the backbone of our economy. Now let's go to the next slide. Next slide is sales and advertisement. Each and every product, company or industry has a very essential and unique point. That point is sales and advertisement. Many times when you are watching some entertainment show with your dear ones, near ones, when you are watching news, you have this Bhangar Cement, Sastaini, Sabse Acha, and all these ads coming in between. That is a part of sales and advertisements. So sales and advertisement play a major role in field of industries, or more specifically, mineral-based industries. The major mineral-based industries include iron and steel, cement, basic and light chemicals, and fertilizers. Some maps that would show you the map of copper and chromite distribution in India. Like copper is most famously found in the Aravalli hillside, and Betul is another famous area to find copper, Santhal, Pura, and many more. And chromite could be found in Guntur, in Mysore, and many more places. If you could please zoom in. Thank you. This is the map. Thank you, friends. Let's go to the next map. This is the map of major oil refineries in India. So major oil refineries, you can find them in many places, like you can see in Kochi, in Vishakhapatnam, in Mumbai, and many more in Panipat. Thank you, dear friends. This was my first topic, mineral-based industries. And now let's go to the second topic. Thank you.
Let's move forward to our next topic, which is cement industry. So cement is one of the basic ingredients for construction activities such as building houses, bridges, dams, and for other commercial establishments. So these industries requires bulky and heavy raw material like gypsum, silica and limestone. Coal and electric power are needed apart from rail transportation and other requirement. Bulky or heavy raw material use karte hain, isliye rail transportation ki isko need hoti hai. And we know that every industry needs an electric power, right? Now let's talk about the cement plant. So So basically, the first cement plant was set up in Chennai in 1904. After independence, the industry expanded. Why? Because we thought of developing our country. Improvement in the quality has found the readily available market in East Asia, Middle East, Africa, and South Asia, apart from a large demand within the country. So thank you everyone. Now our next topic will be explained by Manognya Karamchand.
Thank you, Preeti. Yeah, now let us look at the topic automobile industry. Automobile means which provides vehicle for quick transport of goods, services, and passengers. Examples, buses, cars, motorcycles, etc. Now, where does the vehicle come from? Let's suppose think you went to a market and bought furniture for your households. So where does the furniture come from? Yes, it get manufactured in an industry and comes to the market. Absolutely, here also the vehicle get manufactured in an industry which is automobile industry. Yes, automobile industry means where the companies are involved in marketing, selling, and manufacturing of a vehicle. The components included in automobile industry are body parts of vehicle and engines. The components which are not included are tires, batteries, and fuel. Now, don't get confused. Automobile means which provides vehicle. Automobile industry means where the manufacturing of vehicle is done. After the liberalization, the coming of new and contemporary models stimulated the demand for vehicles in the market. Yes, which means after liberalization, like 1991, when Manmohan Singh became a finance minister, he opened a market for foreign investments. When foreign investments were done, the competition between the industries were developed. When the competition between industries were developed, the growth of industries were developed. When the growth of industries were developed, there was a high demand for vehicle in the market. Yes, by this we can see that there was a healthy growth in the automobile industry. As you can see some states located on the map in front of you. Yes, these are the states where automobile industries are located. So the industries are located in Haryana, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, and Delhi. Let us see some automotive companies in India. Major Indian companies are Ashok Leyland, Tata, Mahindra, Hero Honda, Bajaj, Maruti Suzuki, etc. Major multinational companies are Ford, Audi, Volkswagen, Skoda, Fiat, Toyota, Volkswagen, etc.
So here is our next topic, information technology and electronics industry. So first, let's learn information. What is information technology? Information technology, hota kya? So, information technology refers to the use of computers to store, retrieve, transmit or manipulate data or information. So, information technology is typically used in the context of business purposes as it is opposed by entertainment or personal usage. Information technology is considered as a subset of information and communication technology, jisko hum ICT bhi bolte hain. The role of electronics industry. Electronics industry emerged in the 20th century and today is one of the largest global industries. The contemporary society or the present society uses a vast array of electronic devices produced by automated or semi-automated factories of the industries. Bangalore in Karnataka, India is considered as the electronic and information technology capital of the country. So now let's learn what is the importance of information technology and electronics industry. The electronics industry covers a wide range of products from transistors to television, telephone, cellular telecom, pagers, mobiles, computers and many other products which have become a major part of our daily life. Information technology and electronics has been always playing a vital role in development of activities in agricultural technologies and space research. There are 18 software technology parks in India which have always been providing single window service and one of the best communication facilities for the software experts and users. These industries have also played a vital role in providing employment. Up to 31st March 2005, the information technology and electronics industry had provided up to a million jobs. And this number increases every year though. So here's a map behind me which shows the 18 software technology parks in India, which includes Coimbatore, Bangalore, Delhi, Hyderabad, Pune and many other places. So the next topic will be continued by Arjun.
My comrades, that is industrial pollution and degradation of environment. Let's go. So as you can see, industrial pollution and degradation of environment still make up two different topics. So I have distributed it. The first one being industrial pollution. Again, we'll go back to the basics. What is industrial pollution? Industrial pollution is the pollution which can be directly linked with industries. This form of pollution is one of the leading causes of pollution worldwide. Industrial activities are major source of air, water and land pollution, leading to illness and loss of health and life all over the planet. As you can see these diagrams. What causes the industrial pollutions? I've accounted six causes of industrial pollutions. Some of them being the causes of industrial pollutions are extensive, but here there are some list of top responses. The first response I've got here is industrial growth that is unplanned. So a lot of air and water pollution has occurred from the companies which ignored rules and standard practices. The second being the lack of effective policies. Many industries have been able to ignore, entirely bypass pollution laws. They really don't care about any pollution laws. And they have enforced pollution control and no enforcement of pollution containment boards. Now, as you can see, a lot of pollution all over the world. The number three is the sheer number of industries, the growing number of industries. There are many industries and factories, most of them polluting air every day that we see in our life, we hear about. Small sectors that have rely on from some of the government industries, these companies have been discovered to release significant amount of toxic gas, making pollution an even more substantial issue for smaller industries. Now going to the fourth topic, using old and outdated technology. This would be one more essential reason for polluting the whole world, using outdated technologies. Let's move on. So as you can see, a lot of garbage and a lot of pollution that we humans ourselves are contributing towards the atmosphere, that is our fault. Natural resources are not used. Improper disposal of waste. 6 points. Now let's move on. As you can see this picture. Reducing industrial pollution. This is another significant topic that I am going to cover. Reducing and containing and controlling the industrial pollution. As an harmful effect of industrial pollution increases, there are many agencies and individuals who are working to reduce the pollution, carbon dioxide. Development of better technology of waste disposal is important. Creating policies that prevent land misuse is another important point. Now let's move on. Now going to our third and last topic is degradation of environment. Excuse me. What is degradation of environment? Degradation of environment or environmental degradation is a deterioration of resources such as air, water, land, and which are the destruction of ecosystem and habitat. Environmental degradation is one of the 10 threats officially cautioned by the high level planning on threat. As you can see the photos here. There are many examples for environmental degradation. One of it being that our generation has noticed is the 2019 Amazon rainforest fire.
And an alternate issue that results from this is the overconsumption of waste and paper products that come from those trees. The waste is typically produced, does not get recycled. Therefore, immense amount of waste is created. Environmental degradation has to be reduced. Thank you.
So here's the next topic, methods to control environmental pollution and degradation. So first I will start with water pollution. Methods to control water pollution. So water pollution can be controlled by collecting the industrial effluents at a particular place and then treated and then released into water bodies. As these industrial effluents are highly toxic and may affect the aquatic life. The use of water for processing should be minimized by reuse and recycling. The next method is, water pollution can also be reduced by implementing rainwater harvest for meeting the daily water requirement. Next, for air pollution, in the smokestacks of the industries or the factories, electrostatic precipitators, fabric filters, scrubbers and inertial separators can be fitted. The toxicity of the pollutants released from smokestacks can be reduced and then released into the atmosphere, which may cause less harm. So next, for noise pollution. So noise pollution can be controlled by fitting silencers to generators and heavy machineries, which may decrease a lot of noise pollution. And if feasible, the machineries can be redesigned in such a way that the noise produced is in less amount. And instead of using loudspeakers, earphones and earplugs, we can use other sound absorbing materials such as acoustic foam, sound absorbing underlayment, and other sound absorbing materials such as sound absorbing curtains, cushions, sound absorbing wallpapers and many other things which can be used. So the next topic, which is actually a subtopic from methods to control environmental pollution and degradation, radioactive pollution. So first let's learn what is radioactive pollution. Radioactive pollution refers to the physical pollution of environment of organisms due to release of radioactive substances into their surroundings, and it is caused due to improper handling and disposal of radioactive wastes, improper testing of nuclear weapons, and mining of radioactive ores, other causes. So next let's go to the prevention. The preventions for radioactive pollution are, radioactive pollution can be prevented by selecting procedures in which the volume of radioactive toxins is reduced. And if feasible, the experiments can be changed in such a way that the radioactive wastes are released separately or produced separately from the chemically or biologically hazardous wastes. And the next method is, there are various non-radioactive methods for various assays which may reduce the radioactive pollution. And another method to control radioactive pollution is by avoiding ordering the radioactive material in excess amount which exceeds the intended usage. So with this we have completed our chapter. Thank you for listening.